Huh?
21.
Yes. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى سيدنا ومولانا محمد. أفضل صلواتك وبيان معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه. وعلم وين أوديت أن ما غنمتم that whatever of war booty you have gained for أن لله خمسه. So verily 1/5 of it is assigned to Allah وللرسول and to the messenger ولذل قربا and to the relatives of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم وليتامى and to the orphan والمساكين and the poor وابن السبيل and the travelers. We discussed it in detail, the غنيمة and the faith. إن كنتم آمنتم بالله if you did believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى وما and in that help أنزلنا which we had sent down على عبدنا to our slave محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم ذات يوم الفرقان the day of criterion day of battle يوم التقل جمعان on that day when the two armies faced each other. So that was يوم الفرقان, that was the first impression, which was the last impression as well. That oh, ما قلت العدد والعدد, their number was not that big, they were not that much well equipped, but how they defeated us? Can we counter them next in future? So they said no way, they tried to their best, but they said
No way.
No way, got it? Because you can counter anybody who is fighting for some timely benefits. Yes, but someone who is fighting for ideology, nobody can counter him, nobody can fight him. So they said it's a matter of ideology. Professor, that is good or bad?
It's good.
Yes, yes. And that's why the thinkers from the disbelievers, they know very well that everything is good, but do not allow people to get together based on ideology. That's a trouble. If you like it, they will not, never allow people to get together on the basis of what? Ideology. Got it? Because interests, yes, it can differ from person to person, it can differ, huh?
Person.
From person to person, but ideology cannot differ from person to person. You know what I'm saying? This is the basic point. Ideology cannot differ from person to person. Yes, maybe me and you, we all, we are in the field. Yes, but you have your own interest. Basheer has his own interest, Naseem has his own interest. Yes, so where the conflict of our own interests will come, then we dispute between us, amongst us. Yes, but if all of us, we are in the same field for the same ideology, there is no dispute. There will be only unity. You know what I'm saying? Now look, this is a thread. Yes? Yes, Yana, you can cut it very easily. But add this one to that and then this one, make 10 of them, make 20 of them, yes, now try to cut it.
No, hard.
Yes, that is ideology. Have you got it?
وما أنزلنا على عبدنا يوم الفرقان يوم التقل جمعان.
And that's why, for western interest of different group and different individual, lot of people will be there in the field. Yes, on the other hand, for ideology, there will be only few in number. But this big number, they will not be able to counter them.
Yes, because here there is disputes, or at least there are no any commentators. There is no any commentators, and there is covenant. Yes, and that was going on. That was
going on.
But here you know what I'm saying. That was
going on.
Going on. Yes.
Subhanallah.
وَمَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا يَوْمَ الْفُرْقَانِ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ وَاللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ He has power over every single thing. So here is another issue that وَلِزِلْ قُرْبَى and the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for them, one-fifth of faith or one out of 25 shares of ghanima and booty. That was reserved for who?
The family of Rasulullah.
For family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Agha Sahiba. For who?
Agha Sahiba.
The Agha Sahiba, the Sadat. Sayyidina Hussain radiyallahu barahan, he was a masjid, a small baby, sitting in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Somebody brought a bucket full of dates, and these dates were the dates of sadaqah. The dates of sadaqah, mean sadaqah, the crop. You know what I'm saying? You got it, got it? So Sayyidina Hussain, a small boy, he jumped and picked one. And put it in his mouth, and he did it. Yes, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he put his finger in his mouth and took it out, and he was telling him, Imam Bukhari narrates, that kah, 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 kah. Yes. So Hussain, he was following Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes. When everything was out, then he told him, this is sadaqa. This is haram for us. We cannot eat it. This haram for us. We cannot eat it. The family of Rasulullah, they cannot eat. Well, they cannot take sadaqah. They cannot eat sadaqah. Yes? وَأَبْدَلَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِهَا الْخُمْسَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you people one-fifth of the pay or one out of 25 shares of ghanima. Got it? So now, as you know, that there is no more ghanima and no more fair, people are not giving it, yes, to Sadat. So what the Sadat will do? Yes, they will die of hunger. Family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will be dying of hunger. You know what I'm saying? So that's why some of the scholars, they are of the view that the prohibition of sadaqah and zakat for Sadat was because of this one-fifth. Because of what?
One-fifth.
Of this one-fifth or one out of 25 of ghanima. Now, as fay or one-fifth or one out of 25 shares of ghanima does not exist anymore to be given to the sadaq. So they are of the view that the illah and the cause is gone, now charity is okay for them. Now charity is
okay.
Now say,
it's okay.
Okay for them. But majority of Hanafiya, they are of the view, no. That prohibition of zakat and sadaqat, prohibition of zakat and sadaqat, that was not okay for sadaqat because of two reasons. This reason is not the basic one. The basic reason is, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, innaha awsafu amwal an-nas, that look, you earned. You paid the zakat of your earning or saving in the end of your year, that is just like washing your dirty clothes. That's why it is called zakat. Yes, zakat means purification. Zakat means what?
Purification.
By giving zakat, you are purifying your remaining money. 97.5, it will become pure when you will pay 2.5. When you will pay 2.5, so the remaining 97.5 will become pure. Got it? So it means that 2.5 is actually the dirt of faith.
That is what? That is the dirt of hell. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that is not okay for my family to eat dirt. That's not okay for my family
to eat dirt.
So now the Hanafite said that still zakat and sadaqah is dirt of amwal. So that is not okay for the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what should be done? So they say that it is incumbent on Muslims to give them gifts. To give them gifts. To Awasar, you will give a gift. Yes. When you will find any Awasar that he is poor. He is poor. Yes, if he would not have been Awasar, he would have been eligible for zakat. He would have been eligible for zakat. As zakat is not allowed for Awasar, so you should give him from your own pocket something. You know what I'm saying? And that product and our area, we are doing that. Yes, our elders, they are doing that. They are giving a lot to sadaqah, to bachasar. Bachasar, huh? They are giving a lot. Yes. They are sending them wheat, wheat flour, corn, peanuts,
cow,
sugar cane, cows, lamb, goat. That is for bachasar. Yes. So, even in our area, the poor herdsmen, yes, they have the goats and lambs. They have the basgaran. Yes. So they, every year, yes, they are taking out some of their lambs, 2, 3, 4, giving it to different avasayana. That is for such and such avasay, this is for such and such avasay, this is for such and such avasay. Yes. The others, I mean the farmers, they are sending them bags full of wheat. That is for avasay. It's a gift for avasay. Is what?
Gift.
A gift for avasay. On Eid night, yes, our elders, they go to avasay and give them. At avasay. Yes, that's a well-known practice. That's a well-known practice. That he is a poor man, but he is from the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He cannot take zakat. He cannot take sadaqah and charity. Yes? So, Muslims, they are good guys. They are giving them. Now you got it?
Yes, sir.
Ir antum be udwat ad dunya, and remember when you, the Muslims, were on the near side of the valley. Badr is a valley.
Badr is a valley. Just call Wadi a Badr.
Ir antum be udwat ad dunya, when you were there, and Saudi Arabia, as you have seen, that everywhere there is valley. Yes.
Today there was a good news in the newspaper that Jeddah is also a valley. Yes, Jeddah. And in 2009, some flood came here. Yes. So many people, they lost their houses and things like that. And a few people, they got drowned here. Yes. It was a big flood in November 2009. Yes, when we arrived there for Hajj, so there was a, that news was there, that a big flood a few days before, there was a big flood. So anyhow, at that time, there was one Pakistani guy, he was from Swat, young man, and he was working there as a labor. Yes, but he was an expert in karate, and when the flood came, so he saved the life of 14 people. How many? But he himself got drowned. Yes. But he said, before his drowning, he said,
14
people. So today, King Abdullah gave him the utmost highest award of Saudi Arabia, civil award, which is called King Abdulaziz Award. King Abdulaziz Award, that he has 3 smart daughters back home. So Saudi government will build them a house there in their own area, and will be giving them, I don't know how many 100,000 riyals, and every year they will be providing them something. And the Pakistani government, because of their friendship with Saudi Arabia, yes, they give them 500,000 rupees and they give them a plot in Islamabad. So, bravery is a good thing.
Yeah.
Yes, bravery.
Oh, sure.
Good things. Shri Radha. Good things are there.
Well, excellent.
Huh? Everybody appreciate. Even though the weather can appreciate, brother. Somebody who does not know where, still appreciate what? Yes. Because good character is good character. Somebody whom self can choose, he is a bakhil, he is a miser. Yes, but still he appreciates generosity. Even though he himself does not do that. Yes, that is the case. Yes or not? Professor?
Yes.
Yes. Somebody, he may be having a dirty character, but he does not appreciate dirty character. Mm-hmm. He appreciates noble character. Mm-hmm. Yes? Got it? Somebody will be a thief, but he does not appreciate theft. He appreciates honesty. Mm-hmm. Yes? Yes or not? Because that's human nature. So I don't know that guy, but I was happy because of two, three things. Number one, as a human, he did a great job. Number two, as a Muslim, he did a great job. Number three, as a Pashtun, he did a great job.
So, was he Pashtun too?
He was from Swat, from our area. I don't know him, but close to our area. Got it?
He was Muslim on here.
When you were on the near side of the valley, and they were on the farther side of the valley, was following you and the caravan and the ground lower than you people towards Mediterranean.
That was towards
Mediterranean.
And as you know, at that time for battle, they used to have a mutual consent that what date should be stopped. Mm-hmm. Yes? Arabian culture was like this. That they were, means they were not jumping on each other like this. Yes, what month and what day? Now we are busy because our crops, they were people of such a nature. Yes, so okay. 13th of December is okay with you, then we will face each other. That was their case. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but battle of Badr, I caused it to happen suddenly. I caused it to happen suddenly. Because if I would have left it to your consent, maybe you would have dispute with each other. No, no, they did not do it because I am going for Hajj. You know what I'm saying? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I caused it to you people to happen suddenly.
Walau tawaqattum, and if you would have made, and if you were making a mutual appointment to meet each other in the battlefield, lahtalabtum fil mi'adi, you would certainly have failed in the appointment. Walakin liyabghiyallahu, but Allah did what He did, liyabghiyallahu, so He may decree and He may ordain amran, a matter, kana mafula, which was already done according to the decree of Allah.
Because things happen after that He decrees. What will happen tomorrow? That has been decreed already. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I already decreed that whether it happened. Yes.
لِيَبْزِيَ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَفْعُولًا لِيَهْلِكَ مَنْ هَلَكَانْ بَيِّنًا. So that those who were to be destroyed for their rejecting of faith may be destroyed after the clear evidence. وَيَحْيَا مَنْ حَيَّ عَنْ بَيِّنًا. And those who were to live, they might live after a clear evidence. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ, and indeed Allah is the Sami'un, He is all hearer, alim, and all knower. Is Yurika Mullah fi manamika qaleela.
Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw in his dream, yes, that we are facing a very little number of our enemies. You know what I'm saying? A very little number. So, actually their number was not little. That was a huge number, three times more than the number of Muslims. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his dream. Yes, a few in number. And when he told Sahaba that I saw a dream, that they are few in number, it means that they will get defeated. Doesn't matter how much the number is, they will get defeated. That's what dream means.
As you recall Allah and remember when Allah showed them to you fi manamika in your dream, qaleelan,
very little.
Walau araakum, and if he would have shown them to you kathiran, a lot, la fashiltum, you surely have been discouraged. Walau tanazaatum fil amri, and you surely have disputed in making a decision. Walakin Allah sallam, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved you from dispute and discouragement.
Yes, Allah saved you from dispute and discouragement.
Allahu alim bidhati sudur, he is all knower of what is there in the breast. Wa is yurikumuhum, and remember when you met army of the disbeliever, so yurikumuhum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed to you people that armies in the kingdom when you met them. Fi ayunikum, if we ayunikum, fi ayunikum, in your eyes, qaleelan, a little. Wa yukallimukum fi ayunihim.
So look, they were 1,000, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you people faced each other in the battle of Badr, so I showed the army of disbelievers in your eyes that this is a little army. That is a 100 or 125 people, for example. 100 or 125 people, for example. And you, on the other hand, I showed you people to them a little. They were 80 or 50, 60 people with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, actually, I was pushing you both towards the battle. That it must happen. That it must happen. You should not lose your courage. You should not lose. Oh, they big army. No, this is not that. Make a U-turn. Yes, take an exit. Take what? Anything. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I showed them little to you and showed you little to them. Yes.
Is yurikumum is in the kingdom when Allah was showing to you these people is in the kingdom when you met them fi ayunikum in your eyes qaleelan, little in number. Wa yuqallilukum, and he was making you little fi ayunihim in their eyes. Liyakziyallahu, so that Allah might accomplish a matter kana mafoola, which was already ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ilallahi turja'ul umur, to Allah return all matters for decision. Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, O you who believe, idha laqitum fi'atan, when you meet a force, idha laqitum fi'atan fasbutu, so take a firm stand against them. Wadhkurullah, and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot.
And that's why that is recommended, but that is a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when you are in the battlefield, you say takbir. With louder voice, takbir. Yes, that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. That inspired. That inspired the Muslim, and it frightened the non Muslim. Yes, they want to be, it kills.
Yeah.
This one allowed us. Yes. What it does? It kills the
disbeliever.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu,
ask a second one.
Ya ayyuhal,
not now, at that time. At that time, he had never seen dollar that it was.
Or a hamburger.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, you who believe, idha laqitum fi'atan, idha laqitum fi'atan, when you meet a force, fasbutu, so take a firm stand against them, waskurullah, and remember Allah, kaseeran, a lot, la'allakum tuflihun, so that you may be successful. Wa'ati'ullah, and obey Allah wa Rasuluh and His Messenger. Wala tanazahu, and do not dispute. Fatafshadu. Wala tanazahu, and do not dispute. Fatafshadu, otherwise you will lose your courage. Wa tazhabari hukum, and
depart. Your strength will depart. If you amongst you will start disputing each other, so where is the strength then? Strength comes from unity. Strength comes. And that's why in a battlefield, even the hudud or the Islamic punishments are got dropped. Yes, because it will weaken you. It will create a dispute amongst you. You know what I'm saying? Abu Mahjan al-Thaqafi, I have related to you the story. Abu Mahjan al-Thaqafi, radiallahu ta'ala an, he was a tabi'i. He was
a tabi'i.
Tabi'i. But for battlefield, as you know, that sometime when Saifullah, not Saifullah, should I give you an example? Yes. So sometime Saifullah take tariyat. A lot of what is going on? Yes. So he is taking one?
Yeah.
Opium.
Tariyat? Opium.
Opium. Yes. Because opium, yes, make
liberal.
You know what I'm saying? Then it will be. And that's why for the players, they are doing the dope test.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That somebody has taken tariyat or opium or not. If somebody has taken it, that's against the rule. Mm-hmm. He cannot play. Mm-hmm. That's a crime. You know what I'm saying? So, anyhow, that Abu Mahjan al-Thaqafi, he took a cup.
Of wine.
The wine. Yes. Yes, the battle is coming. When I will take it, then I will see. You know what I'm saying? So when he was come drunk, so he was taken to Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, the Amir. Yes? So the Amir said that actually he cannot punish him because the battle is going on. But he is drunk, so that's why I want to try him. So he tried him to a tree. And Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, he was suffering from fever. So he was on a head top, watching the battlefield from there far. Yes, his fever was, or temperature was 103 or 104. Yes, so when the battle started, so Abu Mahjan, he was watching there from as well, but he was tied to the tree. You know what I'm saying? You know,
yeah.
There are people, some people, they are fond of music. Yes, so when they hear the beating of drum, so they start thinking at home. Yes or not? Yes or not?
Yeah.
If your feet is something else, yes, like that feet, which you are talking about yourself, Allah Akbar.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's human nature. So Abu Mahjan was on that feet, so he said, Ya Allah, I should not look at it. So the wife of Sa'd ibn Waqqas was passing by. So she said, sister, if you can do me a favor. She said, what's that? He said, yeah, you know, I'm not a guy who will run away. I come here. And you will tie me with the same tree. But what is going on? That the battle of Muslims and non-Muslims. I want to take share of that. So if you can untie me and give me the sword of Amir and the horse of Amir. Yes, the horse of the general. So, okay. Yes, Sa'd ibn Waqqas, he was watching there from far flung. So he was. The horses look like Balqa. His horse name was?
Balqa.
And the fighter, his tactics are just like a Ubaja. From that far. His tactics are just like, but he's tied in the tree. I don't know where. Who has got a horse like Balqa and who is the man like Abu Mahjan? When the job was done, when the job was then Qadisiyah was conquered. Qadisiyah was
conquered.
Abu Mahjan came there, he tied the horse in the same tree, gave the sword back to the wife of Sa'd ibn Waqqa, came to his sister, and they're all there. And he didn't ask. She said no. Yes. So, anyhow, then the wife of Sa'd ibn Waqqas told him that actually this was the case. This was the case. So Sa'd ibn Waqqas said, Raziyallahu ta'ala anhu, such a person who has done that great job for the sake of Allah, he should not be punished. And the Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he gave a rule that in the battlefield there is no punishment. Yes, it will weaken your side, it will strengthen the side of other. And maybe the guy will become offended. Yes, and he will rush towards your enemy. He will join them. So not only that, you will lose one person, he will lose his iman. He will lose his iman. Got it?
Wa'ade Allah and obey Allah wa Rasulah and Messenger wa la tanazaw. Wa la tanazaw and do not dispute fatafshalu lest you lose courage. Wa tazhabari hukum and your strength will depart. Wasbiru and be patient and stable. Inna Allah masabirin, indeed Allah is with those who are patient and stable. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ and don't be the like of those خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ who came out of their homes,
the people of Makkah, when they were coming out of their homes towards Badr, so they were beating drums and they were dancing and they were, you know what I'm saying, they were rejoicing. We will go to them. This is the end of their story. Today is the end of their story. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I don't like rejoicing. What happened to them?
وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ and don't be like of those خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ who came out of their houses. بَطَرًا boastfully rejoicing. وَرِيَاءَ النَّاسِ and to be seen to the people. وَيَسُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ and hinder people from the path of Allah. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْلَمُونَ مُحِيطٌ and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala circling and thoroughly comprehending all that what they were doing. وَيَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ and remember when Satan made their evil deeds seeming fair to them. وَقَالَ and he said to them, لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ no one of mankind can overcome you. لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ and he came to them in the shape of a Surata Ibn Malik. Surata Ibn Malik, the chieftain of a big tribe. Chieftain of a
big tribe
in the close by area. And he was telling them that just fight. Just fight. If you are getting defeated, my tribe is here. They are living here close by. We are very much ready. Yes. He came in Shaitan. While Dayana Lawmu Shaitan Amaram and remember when Satan made to them their Amar and evil deeds. Zayyana seeming fair. وَقَالَ إِنِي سَلَّا غَالِبَ لَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ no one of mankind can overcome you this day. مِنَ النَّاسِ from mankind. وَإِنِّي جَارُ لَكُمْ and verily I am your jar.
Jar, actually, jar mean protector. Jar mean protector. Never in Arabic is called jar, because that is the duty of the neighbor to protect each other. That's why he is called jar. In Arabic, neighbor is called what?
Jar.
And what little meaning of jar is? Protector.
Protector.
Yes. So that is the natural duty of a neighbor to protect the neighbor. It's a natural, yes. Arab and especially Holy Quran and Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what a beautiful word they have chosen for neighbor. Jar. Got it?
وَقَالَ إِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ and he said, I am your protector. فَلَمَّا تَرَاتِ الْفِيَتَانِ but when the two armies came in sight of each other and they faced each other. When the two armies faced each other, وَقَالَ so they said and said to the disbelievers, إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِنْكُمْ I have nothing to do with you. إِنِّي أَرَى لَا تَرَوْنَ verily I see what you people do not see because you are looking at the angels. That angels are coming down. Disbelievers were not seeing them, but Satan, yes, he lived with them for a long time. Yes, they were his friends. Yes, a long time ago.
His jar.
Yes.
وَقَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِنْكُمْ إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ
because you are long time friend, he knows all about you. He knows
all
about you. Yesterday, as I was telling you, a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what a beautiful hadith. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَحْبِبْ حَبِيبَكَ هَوْنَمَّا عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ بَغِيْزَكَ أَحْبِبْ حَبِيبَكَ هَوْنَمَّا عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ بَغِيْزَكَ يَوْمَمَّا وابغض بغيضك حولما عسى ان يكون حبيبك يوم ما. If you are friend to someone, yes, so be balanced. If you are enemy with someone, so be balanced. Prophet ﷺ said, don't go to that much depth in friendship even. Maybe tomorrow or day to tomorrow he will become your enemy. So why you are disclosing all about yourself to that friendship? Don't do that. He will be using that against you. Yes, because character is not there. Is there any character?
No.
Say.
No.
Look, yes, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. I know a lot about so many people. Yes, because they were close to me. Now they are our enemy. But have you ever heard I said anything about them? Tell me.
No.
If I have told you that that guy, yes, this is his problem, this is weakness, this is family weakness, this is... Have I told you? No, this is not a good, this is not a character. But Prophet ﷺ said that mostly the human, they are disclosing that. So that's why be mild in friendship and be mild in enmity. Be mild in friendship, Prophet ﷺ says, be mild in friendship. Maybe he will become your enemy one day. And be mild in enmity. Maybe he will become
your friend.
You know what I'm saying? And after Imam Shafi, rahmatullah alayhi, he said to Imam Awzari, Imam Awzari was a little strict man. So he said that, Imam, when we are talking about each other, we should talk, yes, to such a limit that tomorrow if we are sitting in front of each other, so we can look into the eye of each other.
Allah.
Yes, we can look into the eye of. If I will say all about you, so if tomorrow you become my friend and my supporter and something like that, yes, will I be able to look into your eyes? Will you be able to look into my eyes? You know what I'm saying? Our culture is like this, alhamdulillah, that is good. Now we are losing that culture, unfortunately. Yes or not?
Yes.
Yes or not?
Yeah,
even though, if Saifullah has done good to me, Saifullah has done, and now I have become his enemy, so he will be ashamed of my enmity. Even though Ihsan was from his side, I should have been ashamed. But because of culture, he is ashamed of. That sometimes that is. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So that was the character. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the character.
Ameen.
We are losing it. When character is lost,
everything
is lost. When wealth is lost, nothing is lost. Health is lost, something is lost. When character is lost,
everything
is lost. وَإِذْ زَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ وَإِنْ سَيْطَنْ إِنْ شَيْبَ سُرَقَ عَبْدِ مَلِكِ His tribe is called Banu Khas'an. They were very well-known fighters. They were living in the close by area. So Suraqah ibn Malik, in the shape of Suraqah ibn Malik, sit and approach Abu Jahl. They don't worry. We are very much ready. Support is there. Yeah. Support is there. If you are getting defeated, you will see us there in the battlefield.
وَقَالَ عَيْنِي said to them, لَا غَالِبَ لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ الْيَوْمَ مِنَ النَّاسِ No one from mankind can overcome you. وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ and I am your
protector.
فَلَمَّا تَرَاتِ الْفِيَرْدَانِ But when the two armies faced each other, نَكَسَ عَلَىٰ كِبِهِ He made a U-turn.
Very swift U-turn. He made a way.
نَكَسَ عَلَىٰ كِبِهِ made a U-turn. He turned on his heel. وَقَالَ عَيْنِي said, إِنِّي بَرِيٌ مِنْكُمْ I have nothing to do with you people. إِنِّي أَرَامَ لَا تَرَوْنَا I do see what you people cannot see the angels.
I see the angels are coming down.
إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ I fear Allah.
It was a lie. Yes, because he is a well-known liar, professional liar. So he was telling lies. So he said, إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ Yes, I fear Allah. If you fear Allah, why did not prostrate it to Adam then?
إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ I fear Allah. وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابُ
He should have said that I fear these angels. They will destroy me. They will. And especially Jibreel, he can destroy the whole world in minutes.
إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ Allah is severe in punishment. Is يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ
Now this was their case. And that was the case of Muslims. There was a third group and that was the group of Munafiqeen who did not join Muslims in the battle of Badr. Yes? And they were telling each other that actually These people are in self-deception. They deceive themselves. Yes, this small number, they will fight their superpower of their time. They will fight.
No, impossible.
Because people of Makkah at that time were considered to fight their superpower. Yes, they were fully equipped. And these poor Muslims, 306 in number, how many?
306,
not 313. Because 7 out of them, they were in different jobs. They were not in the battlefield. You know what I'm saying? So anyhow, 306 people, they are facing 1,100 well-equipped army. So it means, what they are thinking of themselves? So that's a self-deception. That's what?
Self-deception.
In Persian, that's a khutfarebi. They are in what?
Khutfarebi.
They are in khutfarebi. They deceive themselves.
إِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ remember when the hypocrites said وَالَّذِينَ and those في قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ in whose heart there was a disease or disbelief أَرَّهَاؤُلَاءِ دِينُهُمْ these people, the Muslims are deceived by their religion.
They depend on their religion. Allah is with us. Allah is our helper. Allah is our protector. Today they will see that where is Allah and where is this help. That's what the munafiq was saying.
And whosoever will put his trust in Allah, find Allah Azizun Hakim. So indeed Allah is almighty and all wise. Walau Tarain, if you could see, yatawaffal lazina kafaru. When the angels take away the souls of those who are disbelievers, Al Malaikatu yadribuna wujuhum, and they will be smiting their faces. وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ and their beds, وَزُوقُوا and they will be saying to them, زُوقُوا عَزَابَ الْحَرِيقِ taste the punishment of the blazing fire. ذَلَكَ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ this is because of that which your hands had forwarded before. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ and that is because of that Allah is لَيْسَ بِظَلَّامِ لِلْعَبِيدِ is not unjust to his slaves.
He never